White space. JavaScript has modern programming languages don't care about white space. Spaces, tabs, line breaks, white space are regarded as insignificant, they are ignored. So if I have a file with multiple statements, it doesn't matter if I start adding line breaks between the lines on the start, in the end, or in the middle, this has no impact on behavior whatsoever. In the same way, I can add a few tabs or a few spaces, this has no impact either, the language just doesn't care. He ignores the white space, and just reads the characters that do occur. He ignores the line breaks, because we use the semicolon, to tell JavaScript where the statement ends. And because we do it this way, I can combine multiple statements onto one line. It's no problem on doing this in JavaScript, just makes our code more difficult to read. But the general rules on most programming languages are, one statement, one line. Even inside the statement itself, white space is ignored. On the other hand, I can put multiple spaces in this statement, or I can get rid of a couple of these spaces. The simple rule here is, don't confuse JavaScript, and don't confuse yourself. While I can have this line, var b equals 10. I couldn't take one step further, and get rid of this space. Because now I'm confusing JavaScript, what is var means. He needs to figure it out, where one part ends, and the next begins. So we need the space between var and the character b. Now, we don't need a blank space between the letter b, and the equal sign, and this is because JavaScript knows the equal sign is not part of the variable name, but best practices, there are spaces between the different elements, the different parts of your statement. The only thing is typical is to not use a space before the closing semicolon. You could add one or more spaces, it is perfectly allowed by JavaScript, but the way most people write JavaScript, and other C-based languages, it's to use immediately close the statement with a semicolon. It's just the way we finish the line, like the period in the sentence in English. White space more than anything is simple for readability. If you start to get the elements up against each other, it becomes tough to read. Now, there are two places where white space does matter. The first is, while I could put a space between the variable name and the plus plus sign, and I could put a space between the plus plus and the closing semicolon, I cannot put a space in between the two. And that is because this is not two operators, it is one plus plus operator, is the increment operator, the ability to add one to a variable. The same with minus minus, the same with plus equals. And as you can't put a space on this, you can't put a space on var, or alert, or prompt, or a variable name. And the second white space where it matters, is inside a string. There's a difference between what space, is space, your space, name, and adding a few more spaces to it, and this is because we want spaces to matter inside a string. So when you're creating strings literal, will be regarded as significant. Now, if you want a line break inside a string, for example, here I may want a line between what is and your name. The easiest thing to think is to do this, splitting this line onto another line, but this does not work. You are not allowed to do it this way. JavaScript will get very confused on what is going on. If you want a line break inside a string, we have to give to JavaScript a clue on what are we doing. So what we use is a backslash, to say what is called an escape character, there's a special coming up, that means something other than regular text. And then I say, backslash, n. This looks a little weird, n or name? But JavaScript is concerned, these two characters are special. Backslash n, means, new line. And since I'm using this string in a prompt, and if I say this, we can test this to see what he does. First without the backslash n. You can see the phrase all in one line. And now adding the backslash n. We save it, and test it. we add a break line into the string. On the next video, learn how to add comments to your code.